So I came across this video of a guy pretending to be Zenyutsu on his TikTok channel, which was kind of lame. So I decided to make him an action figure. And that is, I am going to change this boring video into a live action Zenyutsu cutscene. How do I turn this boring video into Zenyutsu if he didn't take the video with the intention of making it a VFX short? So the first thing is to get the virtual clothing, the virtual environments, the hair stimulation, the compositing, the oh my goodness, that's a shit ton of work. After spending hours to create the storyboard, let me explain what is going to happen to you guys. So it's first going to start with Zenyutsu, a close-up, then it moves into a wide shot with a demon standing, or sorry, kneeling down, and he's all like, ah, oh my god, oh my god. Then Zenyutsu goes like, and then he kills him, and that's the end. So the first day was actually spent trying to get the character to morph into the pose that he did inside the video. I'm using a zombie character from Production Crit because I don't have DAS installed on my machine at the moment, so I'm just kind of experimenting. And it didn't work, so. So for the environment, as you guys already know, as taking reference from the anime itself, it's just some sort of a Japanese inside room with some lights and some blah blah. And in Cinema 4D, as you already know, again, I just have to get a cube, then extrude it, then multiply, duplicate, then blah blah blah. I don't think this is needed. So yeah, I actually wanted to try something out with the Voneroy fracture. I don't think I pronounced it right. The Voneroy fracture, where I can kind of create some sort of a ground simulation when my character falls to the ground, and it will make it look more action-like. But I tried rendering in Corona and it didn't work, so I decided to just kick that idea out because it's not really compulsory to create a ground simulation. Still, on the first day, since I didn't have my camera data yet, I decided to get into the hair simulation. As you guys already know, I just have to pick a head model. I just need to fit my character inside the main footage. Then I just have to add the hair, sculpt it, add the dynamics and rehabilitate the physics and blah 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 blah, and then done. It's another day and I still don't have the means to download DAS Studio, so I decided to start with the camera data and animation. So in After Effects, I'm going to import my main footage, and since I'm going to be working with the freeze frame because he wasn't using a green screen and I'm even using low quality video, I am just going to mask out my subject and then create a new composition, create a camera, and then create all the camera animations, put solids at where I want my respective subjects to be, the demon where he's going to end, and whatever the hell that I need. Then I'm going to export all that camera data as a Maxon Cinema 4D file exporter, and am I right? And then get back into Cinema 4D and put my camera data into my environment, and then I can render. And it's actually going to take about 25 hours because I came up with this crazy ass mad ass idea. Since I'm already going to add noise to a CGI image when I put it inside After Effects just to make it look more realistic, why don't I just leave it denoised? So in order to cut my render times, I decided to render at 15 passes with denoising off, so I wouldn't have to add artificial noise and After Effects again.
Oh god!
It's the third day and DAS isn't installed yet, so I can't continue. So I just decided to start playing around with my whole composition. I just started to adjust my environment render, my hair simulation, add some lightning, add some lens flares and blah blah blah. It wasn't really necessary, but I was just trying to cut off my work inside of compositing. Finally, it's Monday. Now I just have to head to Vodafone office, then connect to their Wi-Fi, which is lightning speed, and then start downloading DAS Studio. Now DAS is installed with its model, so now I just have to create a backplate and put my subjects there as a reference. Then I just have to pick a character and then start trying to pose it as the same way, creating an animation before I can now send it into Marvelous Designer, and then I just have to do the cloth simulation and the blah blah blah, and yeah. Now I have to create the cloth simulation inside Marvelous Designer, but before that I think I need to rejuvenate my Marvelous Designer skills by watching a tutorial. Then I just have to now start by creating the cloth simulation, the blah blah. I don't think I have an explanation for this though. I just have to, I don't know how, yeah, okay, so I just have to add shapes, then simulate them to touch the body, then the blah blah blah. After that, then I just have to add a wind simulator and then I just have to export it as an animation and gosh, just watch the video please. After I'm done with the simulation, I just have to now export it as an alembic, or how do you even call it again? Then I now have to go into Cinema 4D and retexture the whole thing, then do the lighting, then make sure that it's on a PNG, alpha matte, and blah blah blah, all these essentials. And then I just have to hit render, and I know this is going to take 95 years, so the whole day was actually spent rendering the cloth simulation, so I just had to watch Sonic, which was a huge bummer. So for the character and the clothing, I actually came up with this weird ass idea of cutting the person's body parts and stitching them to the clothing instead of trying to warp the person's body parts into the clothing or warping the clothing onto the person's body parts. And it actually worked! So for the compositing, it's a very simple process. You have to add each and every single thing that you actually build together into one simple composition. So I had to import my hair, my stitch character to his clothes, my cloth simulation, the whole environment, and then I had to log on to Production Crate. Production Crate is a website that offers the best of VFX assets, sound effects, 3D models, and graphics for your VFX projects. Now, Production Crate actually has helped me since they decided to gift me with a pro subscription. I don't know for how long, but it has helped me since the beginning of time, and I'm sure it's definitely going to help you too. They have a free plan and a pro plan, and as already said, they gave me a pro plan. I actually don't know what I did for them, but thank Production Crate so much for that. Now you can check them out, link in the description, or you can just log on to www.productioncrate.com. Yeah, so continuing with compositing, I can send my subjects into Photoshop, then paint shadows all over them. Since I was not comfortable with painting shadows inside of After Effects, then I just had to add a whole bunch of dust assets from Production Crate, lightning assets, lens flares, and that like fog and each and every single thing. But I was not done there yet. On the seventh day, God rested, but I didn't. I spent the whole day trying to finish up the whole thing and recording the voiceover to add my sweet voice to the whole final video and just make it look so epic and blah blah blah. Then I just had to add obviously a final color grade and then the final video.
I have to save this kid. I have to slay this demon. Thunder breathe. First form, Thunderclap and Flash.